As a technology coach and educator, artificial intelligence is part of my everyday life. Whether I'm setting up chatbots, using hashtag suggestions when posting content, or setting up product ads, I am in constant contact with artificial intelligence. So what is artificial intelligence exactly? Well, artificial intelligence, or AI for short, is when a system or machine displays human-like behavior. A few examples of AI would be when you get suggestions based on what you type on Google Docs, or when you get ads on Facebook after you've made a purchase on Amazon. So with that being said, it's easy to see why it's a benefit for our everyday lives. So let's discuss how AI works. AI is powered by a set of instructions using machine learning techniques known as the algorithm to mimic human-like behavior. My first introduction to an algorithm was when my mother decided I needed my own computer. She set up the Tandy computer and set her then 10-year-old child in front of it. She handed me the cassettes to save my programs and the coding book to choose my designs. Then she left me there. 3 hours later, she noticed that she hadn't seen her child. So she peeked her head into my room to find me typing away, using the coding book to make things run on the computer. Years later, this concept of the computer using instructions to execute an action is used every day to make our daily lives easier. Now, this includes our daily interactions with social media. Social media platforms are websites and apps where users create online communities to share content. So sites such as Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, TikTok, and others use algorithms to run AI to make them appear more intelligent. My first interaction with social media communities was in 2008, when a colleague and myself created a LinkedIn group to help soldiers find jobs outside of the Army. We brought soldiers and employees together in one space. And from these connections, the soldiers stopped being just pieces of paper and became real people to the employers, which resulted in more opportunities and better salary offers. As the group and the engagement started growing, so did the analytics. Because of this, LinkedIn started suggesting our group to different companies and military members that fit the existing demographic of the group. Now, this is an example of the connection between AI and social media. So now that we know the connection between the two, now let's explore the benefits. The benefits can vary depending on your interests. If you are an entrepreneur, then you may be focused on marketing your products. If you are part of a community or professional group, then you're focused on generating leads for your events and workshops. And if you're a thought leader, then you may be focused on presenting and sharing knowledge with others. The benefits are different for each individual, but one thing that everyone on social media wants is an audience for their content, better known as their community or tribe. So let's discuss three benefits from a community building standpoint. The first benefit that we will explore is content creation. When creating and scheduling content on Facebook and Instagram, you can use the Meta Business Suite. It uses AI to suggest hashtags for your copy, to suggest the product to tag in your posts, and to suggest the best days and times for you to post on your accounts. On LinkedIn, it uses AI to suggest posting opportunities, such as sending kudos celebrating new jobs, or even mentioning people on your existing posts to increase the views. While Snapchat uses AI, when it recognizes your face, to get the filters to move when you create your Snapchat content. The next benefit is communication. After you have built and posted your content, you now need to work on creating engagement for your posts. Now, to do this, you need to communicate with both your current and your potential audiences. On Facebook, you can use chatbots when people message you to answer frequently asked questions. You can also use the call to action buttons to direct your audience to a site to sign up, learn more, or to book you. On LinkedIn, you can use the suggested connection feature to invite people to events and groups or to increase your followers. On Pinterest, you can use the suggested ideas feature to see what like-minded people are pinning and then connect and share with them. The final benefit of community building that we will explore is analytics. Now that you have this new community, you have to keep them engaged and interested. So how do you keep them in your community? And then how do you keep the community growing? Now, these are two very good questions, but the good news is that AI can help you with both. So let's say you're looking for more followers like the ones you have. Then you can run an ad with a lookalike audience using the Facebook and Instagram data. Then you can send them to a page or a website using a new or recreated campaign. And on Twitter, you can get suggested lists and topics based on your analytics. And on TikTok, you can get your videos out to the right audience on the For You page, as well as get suggestions of accounts to follow. So these are a few examples of how artificial intelligence has made a positive improvement on social media. Now, we have to remember to have the conveniences that we enjoy, such as lookalike ads and chatbots, the algorithm is necessary. While everyone's community building journey is different, one thing that has proven helpful is to first decide which social media platform you feel the most comfortable with. Then check the analytics section and see if you have been creating consistent content. If not, no worries. You just need to come up with a plan to make this happen. So why is this important? Because the more you interact with social media platforms and leverage the power of the algorithm, the more you will gain reach, following, and community. Thank you.